You know what I'm saying? This dude getting saucy out here, calling me a homewronger, talking about I just want to get with Miss Judy to get the buns. I can't remember what, everything that he's saying. Like, this dude got mad saucy, and this sister is fighting for her life. You know what I'm saying?
Barakata Yahweh, Barakata Yahweh Shai, Barakata Yahweh, Barakata Yahweh Shai, Barakata Yahweh, Barakata Yahweh Shai. Yeah, it's true. She's fighting for her life because she deprived another man of his life. And according to the evidence that's actually in the record, he was deprived of his life unjustly. It was murder, according to the facts that are in evidence. See, the Lord doesn't deal with emotions. It deals with facts. We don't have to be there. I don't need to be there when the ballistics show that he was shot, according to the forensic expert, approximately less than a foot away in his back. That's a fact. So what the attorney was saying doesn't line up according to what the ballistic expert said. The attorney alleged that the man was running down the hall. But according to the expert, it was probably less than a foot away when he was shot in his back. That means he was turning, leaving. The other problem is that if she had anything to the contrary, or if Maharaka had any information to the contrary, the facts would have been submitted into evidence. See, it's a fact that we have a corpus delicti. It's a fact that that brother was found face down, dead, with a bullet in his back. See, that's a fact. It's a fact that she was spotted on camera in her car fleeing the scene. That's a fact. It's a fact that she testified in court that she sold the weapon to someone else. A weapon with a body on it, by the way. Not even concerned about who she sold it to. This way, hey, take this weapon. It has a body on it. I'm sure she didn't articulate that to him. See, these are facts. It's a fact that she lied, which meaning committed perjury, stating that she made the calls from Georgia when the phone record shows that they wasn't made from Georgia. See, these are facts. That's what the law is concerned about, the facts. Speculation, circumstantial, doesn't defeat facts. What get people convicted or freed is the facts and the law. And if you don't bring that forth, it's just mere allegations. So if you had any information to the contrary, or she did, it would have been presented into the evidence. I'm not slandering anyone, but it incenses me that a brother lost his life. He'll never get to do the things with his son that a father should do or enjoy doing. It's really hard out here for men. See, this is the paradigm. If a woman can't, and this is not all women, but if it applies, and in some cases it does, then that's what it is. All of these women were coming forward. They was empathetic for this woman that shot this brother in the back. They was in court. Where are the outcries for the brother that lost his life? Where's your mercy? Where's your heart at? You don't have any remorse for that man. And you're clearly moving with a different type of spirit. Book of Proverbs 17 and 15 say, he that justifies the wicked and he that condemns the just, both of them are like abomination to Adonai. You understand that? You deal with facts. Even in the law of the Torah, Devarim 19, 16 through 21, it says, if a hostile witness stands to accuse someone of wrong, then both the parties involved in the quarrel must stand in the presence of Yahuwah before the Kohen. This brother can't do that because he was shot in the back. And the judges who are in office at that time, The judges must conduct a careful investigation. If the witness turns out to be a false witness and has lies against his fellow Israelite, this is what that sister did. She said she was suffering domestic violence. If she did, why was there no police reports? Why did she leave and go back to a domestic violence situation? If the witness turns out to be a false witness and has lied against his fellow Israelite, give him the same medicine he intends for the other party. So you deal with facts here, man, not emotions. If you had anything to the contrary, why was it not submitted into the record? The fact shows that she was committing perjury under oath. When she was cross-examined, she was caught lying on a few different occasions. But you guys are still showing all this empathy. Where is the empathy for this brother that was shot in the back? Where's the outcry? I mean, what type of people are you, man?
And you don't know the case. You don't have transcript. You don't have the discovery. You don't know enough about the evidence. You know what I'm saying? You just popping off. You ain't speaking with no lawyers or nothing. You just talking. You know what I'm saying? Plenty people out here, plenty black men and women. That's the scripture is Isaiah 42:22, if I'm not mistaken, that's locked in prison houses. There's plenty of people out here getting railroaded.
Yeah, that's true. But the scripture says, keep far from a false charge and do not kill the innocent and righteous, for I will not acquit the wicked. Understand that. Understand that. So that's happening, but in this particular case, that is not what happened. The evidence don't show that. The evidence show otherwise. And if you have anything to the contrary, present the facts and the evidence.
Especially when you ain't got the money and you ain't got nobody backing.
That's what you so-called Negroes believe in. And this is why you're going to get briefcases and you still lose. You spend thousands of dollars. You should have just kept that damn money for your commissary. Chief Justice Earl Warren says 90% of lawyers are incompetent. And I concur. Well, and check this out right here. 9 out of every 10 federal cases, despite the type of lawyer they have, how expensive it is, still go to prison. 9 out of 10. 3 out of every 4 state cases, despite the kind of lawyer they have, still go to prison. So when you're saying they can't afford the money, come on, man. You're living a la-la land. Wake up. I'm going to do you another solid. Corpus Juris Secundum, Volume 7, Section 4, says an attorney's first duty is to the court, to the public, and not to the client. It's a conflict of interest. But you won't believe that because the Negro doesn't read.
You know what I'm saying? But because you Master Rafia, you know what I'm saying, do these videos attacking women, baby mamas, bitches and hoes. Right? This is your language. This is your language, Master Rafia, and I'm talking to you, bitches and hoes, right? You the angry man, Doro, right? You see what I'm saying? Because you have past experiences with women that shitted on you.
I think it's suffice to say that most men had a woman that was not favorable at one time or another. But I like to point out something, man. Listen, people, detach your emotions for a second. The woman in this video that he referred to as Miss Judah, Charise Douglas, she shot a man in the back. She shot this guy in the back in 2021, May 2021. Right? This video you see right here? This is why she's waiting to go to trial for murder. She's out here making rap videos. Look at the facial expressions. Look at the gestures. Does this seem like someone that's remorseful or someone that's concerned about going to trial for murder? Why am I asking you this? It's an interrogatory. Because this is right here. Do you not think that they're looking at stuff like this? She doesn't seem concerned. This doesn't look like someone that deprived someone else of their life and is in mourning and has went to get some sort of counseling. She's out here dancing around like it meant nothing. So the system sees that as cold, heartless, ruthless. Because you're out here making, you know, rap videos, but you murdered your husband. You murdered your husband. And it goes to a stretch of my imagination, Mahavakar, how you would actually get involved with a woman that has done this. I cram to understand that. If you're moving in the right spirit. I don't know. I mean, maybe you guys can answer that. Think about that. You caught a body. You took a life. Y'all have making these videos like everything's hunky-dory. Peaches and cream. Are you saying I'm trying to slander anyone? I'm just trying to get the people to think. The audacity. But what about the brother? What are you going to tell his son when his son grows up and say, where's my father? Where's my mother? Well, your father is demise. And your mother is in prison for murdering her. Do you know what that's going to do to that child? This is what you guys, all you guys that's not empathetic towards that man need to be considering. And you women, that's biased. It's like a life means nothing to you guys. And you talk the Most High? You're only speaking the Most High with your lips.
Much of a response to that, and then what we would call a domestic case, in that Ms. Douglas and Mr. Johnson were actually very recently married. Very, very recently married. And unfortunately, we have been made aware that Ms. Douglas was a victim of domestic violence.
See, the problem with that is just a mere allegation. There was never no facts submitted into evidence of any kind of domestic violence. No police reports, no signs of physical abuse, any of that. So as far as the court is concerned, this alleged domestic violence never existed. What are the facts and evidence?
So this is one of those cases in which the victim unfortunately becomes a defendant, where she had reached out to the Columbus Police Department in regards to calling 911. Unfortunately, there was not really much of a response to that. And then afterwards, Ms. Douglas had to defend herself.
When the phone records were examined, the 911 call showed otherwise. And there's no indication that she was actually defending herself. You see, the facts show that she wasn't defending herself because she shot someone in the back. That's not an indication of one defending themselves. That's someone leaving, turning away. In fact, when you look at the legal definition for a defense, is to drive danger or attack away from oneself. To drive danger or attack away from oneself. This guy was already leaving. He was shot in the back.
At the time of the incident, Miss Douglas was actually fleeing for her life. She had made it known that she was no longer willing to suffer abuse, so she was at the point of transitioning to leave and be back with her family. And then that's the point in which Mr. Johnson began physically abusing her again. Unfortunately, she had to discharge her firearm, her weapon, and Mr. Johnson runs out of the house at that time frame, and then I believe he ultimately collapses outside of the home or somewhere near the home and road.
The real problem with that is the examination shows no markings on this woman, and but it does show that the guy was shot in the back. And according to the experts that examined the wounds on the brother, he was shot at close range, approximately less than a foot.
There was a minor child involved as well, that could have subsequently been killed as well. So she could have been killed, her minor child could have been killed, and that would have been the end of that.
This is all speculation. There's no facts to this. These are all allegations that's unproven, which is why she has 30 years now. Because she's charged with murder and was actually convicted of murder. Everything that this guy is alleging right here was unable to be proven. It had no standing in court. Because these are not facts. These are allegations. This is merely just hearsay. This is her story that he received from her. This is hearsay.
It's unfortunate that a life was taken. But the saving grace is that it was not hers. I believe that if she had not discharged a firearm, you would have a different defendant here today. That's what I really think that this boils down to, is that had she not defended herself as well as her child, we would be reading of the 26th, 27th murder or whatever it is in Muskogee County, and it would have been the exact inverse. So.
The way that he worded that could be easily interpreted as that it's okay that the brother died, so as long as the woman's alive. If you listen well, you can hear the feminist agenda even coming from this guy. According to my opinion.
But you know, we know she's a very sweet person. Like, it wasn't her intention. You know, she's a very nice lady, very nice sister. And we just hope and pray the Most High bring her out of this situation more than anything.
I'm hurt on behalf of my sister, you know, because I got to be strong enough to help my sister be strong. You know, it's an unfortunate event, but I think it had to happen for the world to see that, like, it could happen to any one of us.
If you are here,
I pray that men are taking heed to this. Here's a man that was shot in the back, meaning that this woman's life was not in danger because he was shot in the back. There was no evidence at any times, any kind of markings on this woman's body. They're all allegations, but here you have a group of women coming forth with sounds like feminism, remorseful for a woman that's in prison now for shooting a man in the back that she alleged abused her. But there's never any kind of indications, no police report, no markings on her, anything, just allegations.
Here, in regards to Ms. Douglas, can you please stand? Some of these ladies have never even met her again in their life. Some of them are family, some of them are friends, some of them are advocates, some of them are fellow victims of abuse, and they are all here in order to support Ms. Douglas.
One thing that we must see clearly as humans, none of these women seem to have any kind of remorse for this man that was shot in the back. And they're going off from mere allegations. Just emotions. No facts. No evidence of any kind of domestic abuse. Just her allegations.
People would like to shun women's emotions, you know what I mean? Because we're emotional by instinct, by nature. So, of course, it's easy to say she was emotional and all this, but the reality is she was being abused the whole time.
Where's the evidence of this abuse submitted into the record? There isn't any. What we have is a corpus delicti, is one of our brothers dead, face down.
You know, let's love on one another.
Right.
Keep the Most High prayers, you know what I'm saying? Learn to love and cherish one another, because we don't know when is our last day.
Right.
We don't know when the Most High going to call one of us home.
Right.
Why not cherish and love one another while we're here, while we got the time to do it?
That's a hypocrisy. While this woman is speaking of love, to the contrary, she's showing no love whatsoever for this man that's now in a coffin that will never get to spend time with his son again.
William said Johnson had wanted to get out of the marriage after Douglas told him she had previously been institutionalized for anger issues. Witnesses said Douglas left to return to her Memphis, Tennessee home and found out she was pregnant. The couple tried to reconcile, but things quickly deteriorated. At 8:37 p.m. on the day of the murder, Douglas texted Johnson, asking for $45 Cash App to leave, and said she didn't want to cause strife.
So at 8:37, she texts him, tells him she wants to leave. 5 minutes later, she texts, "Sister, I'm about to kill dude."
At 8:42 p.m., she texted her sister, "I'm about to kill dude." Kyle Tuggle with the Columbus Police Department testified Douglas's next text, highlighted by the defense, "He put his hands on me," did not come until 40 minutes later.
So she texted she was going to kill him, went and did it. Then she tried to text to make it align with the other text, but the record showed that that text came 40 minutes later. The guy was already shot.
At 9:22 p.m., according to phone records. The 911 call placed from the neighbor who found Johnson shot was placed at 8:58 p.m.
So at 8:58, the guy was already found face down, shot in the back. And then she texts later at 9:22, "He put his hands on me." She'd already shot the guy.
Douglas showed no sign of injury when she turned herself over to Columbus police days following the incident.
So there was no evidence that she'd actually ever been shot.
The right side of the pit, isn't it?
Surveillance footage picked up Douglas's vehicle leaving the apartment complex in the minutes following the murder. Other surveillance shows a calm Douglas making stops at an Opelika, Circle K, and Dollar General, matching receipts which were found in Douglas's ditched car.
She shot this brother in the back, went and made two stops. On the camera, her body language was extremely poised and calm, and then went and sold the gun in Alabama.